Hello, everybody. So I think we can all agree in this room today that Leonardo da Vinci was a lazy piece of shit, all right? Because I had heard that he invented all these marvelous things like the helicopter and the tank. But what I didn't get told, that he just sort of drawn pictures of this shit and just been like, that's enough, all right? If I came here today with a drawing of a picture of hover boots that I'd made, and I said, I've created a pair of hover boots, you'd probably go, well, do they fly? And I'd say, look at the picture, they're flying. But I doubt I'll get into a museum with that shit anytime soon, you know? But no, it'd be tough to invent stuff, to give credit to him, you know? I think if you chuck me into a room full of raw materials and said, you've got 4 hours, fucking go ahead, all right? I could bring you a stick for hitting, a stick for poking, and my favorite of all the sticks, the proto-dildo, okay? It hasn't got on switch, but I've come up with a method. Cup, 8 cups of coffee immediately and you're ready to go, all right? I think it'd be tough to invent something. I reckon that if any one of you was fucking blast back, right, in a time machine all the way back to the past, 1600 BC, right, let's say Celtic era Britain, very long time ago, and you appear in some village and the tribe leader comes up to you, might look a lot like this gentleman here, he comes up to you and he says, future man, you have 3 days to bring me an invention, okay, from the future, okay? And if you can't do that, we're going to bludgeon you and we're going to fucking eat you. You'd be shit scared. You'd be shit scared. Day one, you'd be walking around going, oh, fuck me, I've got to come up with something here. I must have something in the tank. Dragon's Den. What we got? We got the Trunky. We got the Sponge Daddy. We got reggae, reggae sauce. Put a little bit of music inside your food. But, but the first two are made out of polymers. The first two made out of polymers and the last one's made by some fucking lyricist Jamaican guy and you have to invent a fucking Jamaican to invent the bloody sauce. You can't do that and you're thinking, ah, oh, this is stressing me out. This is stressing me out, but I'm in the past, okay? So why don't I just fucking enjoy myself? I'll enjoy the evening. So, you know, you get yourself a glass of the finest ancient ale. Delightful. And you look across the sunset and the untouched majesty of the land and you look to your left and there's a fucking public hanging going on there. And you're thinking, okay, shit, you know, I would say a stoning, but I just feel that hangings are more of an evening activity, you might say. That didn't work on my brother either, but anyway. So that's day one squandered. Day two rolls around, all right? You wake up peppy, but you realise that people don't really get you, so you're kicking dust up around, you're chucking out a few bazingas. Bazinga, because they haven't seen Big Bang Theory, all right? So they don't know. They just think you're fucking hysterical. So that's that. But in the evening comes round, day two, the evening, and you think, good crikey, I've got to come up with something. So you skulk around all the tents in the village at night, and you see what they've got, and you see, fuck shit, they've already got farming. Fuck shit, they've already got a bow and arrow, all right? And then you look into one tent, and you see inspiration, a pestle and mortar. Okay, so you run into that tent, you snatch that shit, and you run out into the village tent and you go, bazinga, bazinga, I've got it! Bazinga, everything's going up, Milhouse Bazinga! You say, animal guy, get out here, leader. He comes out, you say, I want your strongest hunters and gatherers off to the woods. I want nuts, I want leaves and shit. And I want, what was the other bloody word? Salt! So you get, you know, you say, all right, be back tomorrow and I'll make you this fucking invention, okay? So they wander off to the hills, you get a good night's sleep, wake up early, hit the stoning. You're getting into them a little bit now, so yeah. And the riders come over the hill with all the stuff and they say, Oscar, we've got your shit. And you go, just give me five, because this is actually about to get really good. So just give me a sec, all right? And then they go, no. So you take that shit off of him, and you go up to Amalguide's tent, and you go, Amalguide, welcome to the future. So you fucking grind that shit up in your pestle and mortar, and you say, Amalguide, I'm going to make you so proud. And you say, Amalguide, the future's going to be different now, Amalguide, welcome to the future. And he takes the bowl off your hands, and he wipes his finger around the side of the bowl, and he looks at it, and he tastes it, and he says, oh, this is pesto. And that's my story about Leonardo da Vinci or something. Anyway. There you go. Have a good evening, guys.